thought that inflation may be at its peak right now. Is that the determination of your economic team when they look, when they analyze kind of the state of play in the market right now, or where is he kind of basing, what's he basing it on?
Well, I think if the president were standing here, I know he's always invited, which may be the next thing someone says, but which is okay, you're invited if you're listening. Would be that we, of course, defer to the Federal Reserve and their assessments that they make as they make predictions about inflation. They are predicting, as outside economists are, that inflation will come down next year. So we would really defer to them, as would the president. I think I have not obviously had a chance to speak to him post his comments because it was just shortly not so long ago, but I think what he is in his mind, as he went on to articulate, is what we're doing to lower costs for the American people. And that's how he sees it, is, of course, inflation is a term we use here. We use it at the Federal Reserve, a very important economic term. The way the American people experience this at home is costs and what things cost, whether it is the cost of gas or natural gas, heating your home or putting gas in your car. We're seeing those prices come down, or whether it is buying a car, again, we're projecting those prices will come down. We're obviously working to bring the cost of food down. So we are seeing those move in a good trajectory and in a good direction, and I think that's how he was articulating it.
And then you guys have been consistent on your argument as it relates to Build Back Better and inflation now for weeks, if not months. Senator Manchin has been consistent in his position for weeks and not months. Obviously, something is going to need to change in that dynamic on the senator's side of things for him, I presume, to support Build Back Better. What changes in your argument that resonates with the senator, given his long-held positions here on inflation?
Well, we will certainly let the senator speak for himself. He will, of course, be speaking with the president, as the president alluded to, early next week. And I would expect the president will convey much of which we've conveyed publicly, that while we've seen costs increase in some areas, and we've seen a good them move in a good direction in some areas as well, what we need to do now is think about what we're going to do about rising costs. What is our plan to address rising costs? You know, you saw every single Republican in the House vote against Build Back Better. What were they voting against? Yes, they were voting against the president's agenda. They were also voting against lowering costs. They were voting against lowering costs for childcare, lowering costs for elder care, lowering costs for health care. And I think not argument, because he has a very good working relationship with Senator Manchin, but I think the case he will make is that this is exactly the time to pass this bill and move it forward so that we can lower costs for the American people on all of those topics, including insulin, in areas that really force American families to pinch pennies.
Go ahead. On that same point, though, just politically, do these numbers make it more challenging, you think, to pass Build Back Better, given the fact that opponents and even Manchin argue that pouring more money into the economy will only make things worse?
Well, what we know is what 17 Nobel economists, Nobel laureate economists, have conveyed, which is that this will help address inflation. We know that economists across the board, many, many across the board, have conveyed that this will help address what we see as rising costs. And we also know that for American families sitting at home, they don't necessarily think of it as what the data and what the economists are saying. They think of it as what their daily, what their weekly budgets are, what their monthly budgets are, and which leader has a plan to address that. So actually for us, politically, arguing we're going to bring down the cost of childcare, we're going to bring down the cost of preschool, we're going to make affordable housing a reality, and on the other side of the aisle, you have people who are opposed to lowering that cost, is a pretty viable argument.
And on the timeline here, just to put a finer point on it, you noted some the costs are already going down that may not be reflected in this report, and that you may see changes next year. But if, you know, you're an American at home worried about these rising prices, how long do you think Americans should be prepared for these increased prices to persist?
Well, I think the way the American people look at it is not through data. Right? They look at it through how things are impacting their lives. So what they can know is that gas prices are coming down in about 20 states across the country. We expect that to happen in more. Natural gas prices are coming down. That means if they're looking to heat their homes, it was a very cold day here yesterday, for other cold days around the country, those prices are coming down. If they're looking to buy a used car, those prices should come down early next year. And also there are steps we're taking to address areas of where we see prices increasing, like when they go to the store to buy some, you know, burgers for a barbecue, that we're working to go after meat conglomerates for raising prices and jacking prices up. So it's area to area, but what we can tell them is where we're seeing progress, where we're still going after the problem, and what we would also convey to them is you should look closely at who has a plan here and who's just shouting from a megaphone about it being a problem. We all agree it's a problem. It's who's going to do something about it.
How worried are you that the Fed may have to raise interest rates?
We really, of course, defer to the independence of the Federal Reserve in making those decisions and what they feel is right for the economy. So I wouldn't say we're worried. We leave them to their independent assessment of what's needed. Go ahead.
Jen, is the mentioned conversation happening here at the White House in person or by phone?
I don't have anything on the format. And obviously, we've been in close touch with Senator Manchin, but I just was echoing what the president said just a few minutes ago.
And then on